Hello, and welcome to The Shift Change. I'm Shelby Green, and it's August 18th. Already looked it up. Moving on. Today, actually, I was going to talk about two things. A short list, but that won't keep this video short, because it never does. The first thing is a friend of mine. She's trans. She's starting hormones. Sorry, I've got the notes over here. She's starting hormones in about a month. And she had a couple questions, and it's always fun. And if you're out there and you're trans, everybody invariably has somebody that they end up talking to when they start getting ready to go through this. Of course, we all find our big sisters, big brothers, whatever. And then invariably, you will end up being the same thing, whether you like it or not. You'll have somebody somewhere come out to you because they see you being trans, and they realize they can be, or they realize they can talk to somebody who they trust about it. It's one of the best parts, to be perfectly honest. I think it's fantastic. So anyway, the point being is, a friend of mine, she's getting ready to start hormones in about a month, and she asked me about the emotional thing. And this is one of the things that I don't want to downplay things, but at the same time, I think there's a lot of overblown stereotypes in the standard trans narrative. You know, it's this whole thing, it's like, oh, I'm going to start hormones, and I'm going to go... Yeah, you know, gonna go batshit crazy. I don't like that because I think there's a lot of misogyny in the idea that these hormones instantly make people crazy, i.e., women are crazy. What's wrong with that? Lot, you know? What I want to tell people out there is that what's actually going on here is the fact that it's not that you're feeling more or you're reacting too much to what you're feeling, it's the fact that you're being allowed to feel. In my experience, and this is mine, obviously, it's mine. You can't have it. Don't take my experience. I don't know how you do that. Brain leeches or something. In my experience, what I noticed is the fact that not that I felt more, is that I was allowed to feel. I think that socially, there are things that a lot of guys get screwed over on. Very few. And it doesn't balance out the huge gains that are given to the male sex, or the male assumed sex, or the male persona. And one of those things that's kind of screwed up is that men are told flat out, you can't feel, you can't have any feelings. And I don't think that I have new feelings since I started transitioning, but I think I'm allowed to feel. You know, I think guys feel kind of the same things that we do, it's just that it's turned off. You know, it's truncated. Your scale goes from 1 to 4. You're not allowed to have anything over 4. You know, my scale goes from 1 to 10 now, or 1 to 50, or whatever. And it's one of the things that bothered me the most during my life, is I never felt connected, I never felt really emotionally linked with another person. You know, my capacity to love and care about things was stunted. It's the best word for it. So, if you're thinking about, you know, HRT, you're starting hormones, specifically estradiol, I'm not a big fan of progesterone myself, but, yeah, you're going to feel more. Because you're letting yourself feel more, you're opening up to it, and, you know, my favorite particular event of this was that I was still passing as male. I hate that term. I still looked male. When we went to the gym, I still looked male. Didn't want to push that at the time. I was early on in my transition. And went to the gym, and I was on one of the elliptical machines, and I was watching TV.
I remember this.
So says the wife. And I was watching TV, and it was an episode of Stargate. Which is an okay show, fun show, and a character on Stargate died. And I was bawling. And it was hilarious because I was watching it like, no, this isn't even like, you know, a serious movie or anything. I'm like, oh my god. And I couldn't stop. So, you know, I was like, why am I giving a crap about this character because she's dead. And she does this stuff, and it was like this instantaneous connection. I'm like, oh my gosh. So I'm sitting there at the gym, trying desperately not to bawl, but at the same time, I'm like, this is amazing. You know, that's just really cool. So, personally, I think it's a plus. You know, it's going to make you feel a little weird and a little unstable at times, but rock on, you know what? You can cry, but you don't have to. Guys don't get to. It's a horrible stereotype, because there are guys out there that have overcome this, or are more sensitive. You know, I see one as a limitation. You know, I don't see... what we do feel now, or what I feel now, or what women feel, if any of this is even true, as an excess. How can you feel too much? Anyway, second thing to talk about really quick is statuses. Yay, status. As I've become more and more comfortable with myself as who I am, and kind of finally gotten over the big hump of worrying about my face every 5 minutes, because, you know, I got my the Texas chainsaw thing. No, I'm just kidding. The good job by Dr. Z, yay for him, but as soon as he's done now, I'm moving on, I'm just waiting for some of the final little swelling to go down, yay rah. But now, since that's not primarily, you know, first and foremost in my brain and on top of my head, I've started kind of noticing that when we go out, when me and Hilly go out, there's a new status that I'm noticing that I think is clicking on for people, and that's lesbian. I really never even paid any attention to it. I mean, I just didn't give it the time of day because I was trans, and that was the number one thing that everything was, and I'm still trans, but now I'm sort of seeing the various nuanced shades, and it's like, whoa, we go out, and if I don't think somebody's, like, looking at me and going, trans, no, but they have moved on to, two girls, which is hilarious, because I play this horrible game in my brain. I'm like, well, is it worse to be trans or to be a lesbian? For that person. Don't know, don't care. You know, it's entertaining, but it's unique, the fact that I've had to notice a new status, which I just never even paid attention to before. So, and it's nice. It's nice. We go out. We don't hide it. I mean, we're not playing tonsil hockey, you know, in the middle of a crowded street, although it wouldn't be remiss to do so.
Noted.
I'm in trouble now. Mm-hmm. Eek. But we do hold hands, we do a lot of other stuff, you know, walking around in public. And I don't care. I used to be a very closed-in, super paranoid person, and that's just breaking down. It's all falling apart. It's so funny that stepping into these I shouldn't say stepping into. I'd say acknowledging and becoming these statuses. While technically it's less normative and it's more dangerous, because it is, I'm more open now than I was as a guy. I have less fear now of the world, even though I have better reasons to fear it, because I'm stronger, you know? And it's that ephemeral kind of weird stuff that happens when you transition for some people. I think for a lot of people, actually. That's the reason to do it, you know? You can be so much stronger when that strength comes from a pure, authentic source. Golly! So go get them. I'm amusing the hell out of myself today with my straggly hair. So, just realized I have, like, no makeup on. Anyway, I'm Shelby Green, and this is The Shift Change on August 18th, Saturday at 1:10 p.m. or something. And I think I'm off to go play pointless video games with my wife, who's a lesbian. It's true. And that's the button that makes things stop.